WNBA Skills Challenge underway. You can do better than that. Make some noise. First up, from your Phoenix Mercury, Brittany Griner. DJ.
Here is PG, beloved by this hometown crowd. Forgot to bounce the first pass, but then gets all three bounce passes through. Now we'll try the chest pass. If she doesn't get it through on this time, she still just moves on. But she does. Actually, how about the three from BG?
She's shooting the three ball well this year. On
4
10
for
attempts.
10? Yeah, yes. Not bad. And hits the second one. The little elbow jumper. All right, BG, we see you. Move through the little lightsabers. How about the corner three from Brittany Griner? In and out, but that's okay. Once you don't get that third one, you move on. Another pass, that one is through. And this, you could do whatever you want. Oh, wondered if PG would dunk it. Instead, she lays it in.
And that's time. With a mark of 46.3 seconds, make some noise for Brittany Griner.
So the first one, she forgot that you have to do a bounce pass.
That's
so
right.
Wasted a couple of seconds with the chest pass.
About that three-stroke looks very comfortable for Brittany Griner now, though.
Yeah, she's got the interesting side rotation on it as well.
Well, let's take a listen in to Alicia Gray, Sounds of the Game.
I figure out what strategy I want to approach. Because I put too much backspin on it. I don't want to tire myself out because I got a whole 3-point competition to shoot for too. So I ran through the whole shooting course, right? Girl, by that fourth rack, girl, that story ball?
Alicia Gray about ready to go. She will be our second participant in the Kia WNBA Skills Challenge.
Next up, from the Atlanta Dream, Alicia Gray.
Ready to go. Did she really say she didn't want to tire herself out for the 3-point competition during the skills competition?
Well, she's off to a good start.
Wow.
I mean, she is blazing through this.
Come on.
Alicia Gray.
There she goes.
On that three. How about the elbow jumper? Okay. Alicia. Yeah. Avoid Darth Maul.
Is lightsabers the official description?
Feel?
Oh, it 100% is.
Yeah, I mean, we are a Disney company after all. Alicia Gray burning to the bucket.
Wow.
31.2 seconds. Alicia Gray,
and
very
that
impressive.
Is time moving into the lead with a score of 30.
I mean, look how quickly, and she doesn't waste any time grabbing the ball and bouncing it through. Then this one fires it. Boom. I don't know if you can get much faster without just making every pass on the first try and every shot on the first try.
No, that was sensational. And what's interesting is, so the first two participants, the clock goes up. Now it goes down because we know they have to beat the time of 46.3 from BG if they're going to advance.
Clever.
Contestant from the Connecticut Sun, Marina Mabry. DJ.
I'm Marina Mabry, who has not played a game for the Connecticut Sun, wearing a Connecticut Sun uniform for the first time here at the All-Star Game after being traded by Chicago.
Okay.
And Marina's off to a great start. You see how the clock is counting down now instead of up, because she has to beat Brittany Griner's 46.3 seconds to have a chance to advance. Mabry, always a threat from three, knocks down that corner pop. Oh, a little fumble. Going back, making the pass on target.
Oh no.
Another fumble. Mabry able to lay it in and beats BG's time. So Brittany Griner is officially eliminated.
You know what I really like about this competition? There are three officials in uniform standing on the sideline. I'm not sure exactly what they're doing. So Ryan, I need you to give a different saber-wielding character from Star Wars with each new contestant.
Can it be... Does it have to be people who only use red sabers?
No, they can use any color.
Okay, all right, gotcha.
And, oh, twice.
All right.
Next up, from the Indiana Fever, Kelsey Mitchell.
So Kelsey Mitchell wearing Erica Wheeler's jersey because Erica was supposed to compete in this, had flight trouble. So Kelsey, who's an all-star, competing with her teammate's jersey. That's going to slow her up a little bit. There you go. That pass goes through.
Make up time here.
The time to beat was 35.1 seconds if she's going to advance. That was the time for Marina Mabry.
Saber-wielding character?
Well, that one obviously is Kylo Ren. Gonna take a third three here from Kelsey. She's gonna run out of time. Kelsey Mitchell, who may be the fastest player in the league, is not gonna make it today as Kelsey Mitchell is eliminated. Rocking Erica Wheeler's jersey as her teammates, Caitlin Clark, Aaliyah Boston, also all-stars here on the sideline watching. There they are, catching the action. Good to show some love to their teammate as Kelsey comes up just short. Maybe it was Erica's jersey that didn't provide the luck.
Maybe.
A built-in excuse.
And our final contestant, from your Phoenix Mercury, it's Sophie Cunningham, DJ.
1, 2, ready, go.
All right, Sophie Cunningham has to be 35.7 seconds. If the Phoenix Mercury will have a representative in the final, the skills challenge off to a good start, or three. In and out, gonna have to take it again. If she misses this, one more attempt. You hear her screaming, wearing a mic for us. Knocks that down, that one. As of now, it's Mabry and Gray in the final. Can Cunningham top them? Around Yoda's lightsaber, she cannot. Yes, Yoda's lightsaber is actually green. Cunningham beats the buzzer with 0.2 to spare. Sophie Cunningham is going to the final to face Alicia Gray.
How great is it that the Phoenix Mercury get out one of their hometown folks here in the finals? And then here, she got past Yoda, fired it through. I mean, she was under the gun right here. She could see the clock going down.
I mean, 0.2. Yeah. And a little style as well. So, round one is done. Alicia Gray and Sophie Cunningham advance. They will meet in the finals.
Well, we are so excited to have the finalists here with us tonight. Okay, I have to talk to Alicia first because your pace out of the gate, I think you put everybody on notice with the speed. How were you able to get out of the gate so quickly?
I just depended on my speed. I knew I had to go fast. I mean, fast is the game, so try to have the lowest time as possible. Yeah, I was just gone for real.
You're the leading scorer for Atlanta, so we didn't get surprised at all with the shooting, but I thought your passing was on point. How critical is it to get that on the first try?
It's definitely critical. I mean, it knocks into your time, so you got to be accurate and stay locked in and focused.
All right, Sophie, you had to play point guard one game this season. I see the passing out there. Okay.
Did you hear that, coach? Our new point guard, Tosh, you're out of there, bud.
Never. But you are doing so great for this home crowd. You know, BG got knocked out early. How are you keeping that spirit alive for this home crowd to get into it for you?
Y'all, I thought you were pretty quiet. I thought you were quiet. Where we at? Where we at, X Factor? This one will be a lot better for the both of us, so we're excited for it.
Okay, what was the hardest skill that you felt like, okay, I got to lock it down this time?
Honestly, I'm out of breath. I think it's my conditioning. But honestly, that little thing over there in the corner, that can go. It's not my favorite thing.
All right, we're calling it the lightsabers. I don't know what you guys want to call it. Was it hard for you too?
A little bit. I mean, I just was dialed into the rim, honestly.
Okay, she's dialed into the rim. That's the technique. Don't get distracted. Don't get distracted. X Factor, we need to hear you more. Bring it in. Bring it in. Thank you.
All right, Holl, Alicia Gray, Sophie Cunningham about to compete for the championship of the skills competition. Let's take a listen into Sophie Cunningham's sounds of the game.
Get it, baby! Ayo! I'm nervous! I didn't get eliminated.
Well, Sophie Cunningham did not get eliminated. It's Sophie Cunningham against Alicia Gray for the championship. Trying to get that crowd going in the building.
First up in the final round of the Kia WNBA Skill Challenge from the Phoenix Mercury. Make some noise for Sophie Cunningham, DJ.
All right, here you go. Three straight bounce passes that need to go through. They all do for Cunningham. How about this pass? Yeah, the skills are there. The three in and out. The second one's off. We'll take the third. Make or miss. She moves on. Missed them all to the elbow.
Oh, my foot!
Oh, I think Sophie was upset with herself.
Here we go.
Avoids Darth Sidious. Can hit the corner three. Does hit the second one. We know how fast Alicia Gray went with a 31.2 time on her first as Cunningham chimes in at 34.5 seconds.
And that's time for Sophie Cunningham. 34.5 seconds. Setting the mark. Fans, make some noise for Sophie Cunningham.
Gets it on the second one, and then no problem, fires this one through the giant hole, and then finishes it strong, but still, it's fast enough to put pressure on Alicia Gray for sure.
Yeah, she cut a second off her time. Now remember Alicia, who just was so fast, did it at 31.2 her first round. She needs to be 34.5 here to win.
And now from the Atlanta Dream, make some noise for Alicia Gray, DJ.
I love that she needs the protective eyewear.
Yes.
For the skills competition.
I agree. But, I mean, she is ridiculously fast at this. It's unbelievable how quickly she gets through all those passes.
To keep the wind out of her eyes.
Misses all the threes. Hits the elbow jumper.
We got?
Avoids Lord Vader. Airmails the first. Has to take all three. This is going
to
be
this
tight.
This has to go through.
Alicia Gray gets it through. Alicia Gray is your champion. With 2.4 to spare, Alicia Gray, your 2024 Kia Skills Challenge
and with
time champion.
32.1 seconds.
Renee Montgomery loving it. Her member from the Atlanta Dream.
then 32.1. Sophie Cunningham knows, yes, I was bested. An impressive performance. Last year was Kelsey Plum. Year before was Sabrina Ionescu. This year, it is Alicia Gray, the winner of the Kia Skills Challenge. All smiles with Commissioner Engelbert. Sophie Cunningham and her teammates, Brittany Griner, Natasha Cloud. All chatting it up after the competition. A good effort from Sophie in front of her owner, Matt Ishbia, and these Mercury X Factor fans. But the title goes to Alicia Gray.
Where WNBA Commissioner Kathy Engelbert and Kia America's Vice President of Marketing, Russell Wagner, are presenting the 2024 Kia WNBA Skills Challenge Trophy to our champion, Alicia Gray. And now, please welcome ESPN's Holly Rowe.
Okay, Alicia, you got off to such a quick start. Your pace, it continued to amaze us. You're still trying to catch your breath. How important was that in the start?
Well, I knew in the first round I had to at least, you know, match the time. And I seen what time Sophie has, so I need to go even faster.
Yeah, it did put a little pressure on you there at the end. How did you finish so strong? You missed a couple of shots, but then you put on the burners after.
I started so fast, so it gave me like a little padding on the end. It was all part of the strategy because I knew the second time around I was going to be a little fatigued from the shots, so I had to make my passes accurate.
I saw Renee Montgomery, one of your owners from the Dream, here supporting you, giving you some extra love. How much is it for you to be here in front of all these fans having a great time rooting for you?
I mean, it's amazing. I mean, the W fans are amazing. I mean, we wouldn't be the players we are without them, especially with the home court advantage and stuff. So thank you, fans.
All right, you said you didn't want to tire yourself out because you still got the three-point competition. What if you made some history tonight and won both? Can you do it?
It's a possibility.
All right, stick around. We're going to see if we can make some history tonight.
Thank you.
All right, Holly, Alicia.